Good day to all my fellow travelers, photographers, and friends around the world. Chris Lee here. Welcome to my travel channel. In today's episode, this is the third and also the last episode of my travel journey to Cambodia. Now, in this episode, I'm going to share with you a very unique piece of my travel history in one of the Southeast Asian country, and the name of this country is Kingdom of Cambodia, and it usually referred as Cambodia alone. Now, this trip of mine to this ancient Angkor Wat city was done in the year 2007 and in the month of September, right? And it was during a monsoon season. It was an impromptu travel journey without any prior plannings, and the time spent in this ancient city was less than 4 hours. Now, the tour, right, took place in the afternoon on the day of my arrival in Siem Reap by boats. Then it was entered by a late evening rain, unfortunately. Thus, the whole journey in Siem Reap only lasts about 19 hours from 1 p.m. on the day of arrival until 8 p.m. the next day before leaving. Now, as mentioned in earlier, that the journey took place in the year 2007. Thus, all the images that I'm sharing with you today were of 14 years old. I believe all these images, right, may not truly, right, reflect the current condition in Angkor Wat and Siem Reap, but it does give us a better understanding of the Cambodia past, a valuable piece of documentary travelogues. Now, if you plan to visit Angkor Wat in the near future, please stay tuned until the end of this travelogue, as I will be sharing with you some tips on how to plan and what to prepare for the trip. Alright, soon after the end of my trip image presentation today. Now, to begin with, let's look at the maps of Cambodia and have a better understanding of the whereabouts of Siem Reap city and the background of this touristic city of Cambodia. Now, Siem Reap is a provincial capital city of Siem Reap, located at the northern bank of Tony Sap Lake in the northern Cambodia. It is the second largest city in Cambodia after Phnom Penh. Now, a city that built under the influences of both Chinese and French. Hence, in the old city district, one could locate many buildings constructed with the combination of French colonials and Chinese style of architectures. Now, originally, the city was formed by a cluster of small villages seated along the Siem Reap River and got its name from the same river. Now, Siem Reap River is one of the many tributes discharged into Tony Sap Lake. Now, the city is getting very popular amongst the world travelers due to close proximity to Angkor Wat archaeological site nearby. Now, for this reason, every two visitors to Cambodia, one of them will be visiting Angkor Wat or Angkor archaeological site. Hence, 50 of the jobs created in this city is linked to tourism and hospitality businesses. Now, Siem Reap City, the heartland of Siem Reap Province, is a popular tourist destination endowed with plenty of entertain and plenty to entertain any visitor beside their world-renowned archaeological site nearby. Nightclub, pub, bar, and discos come alive after sunset. Now, during the night, visit the pub street, which close to traffic in the evening, and the Angkor Wat night markets, which have over 200 souvenir shops that sell traditional Cambodian handmade products, right? And such as cloths, silk pieces, arts, jewelry, wood and stone carving, and many more other interesting items found perhaps only in this part of the world. So please look at the map again, the same maps. The red arrow is pointing to the location of Angkor Wat archaeological site, and is more commonly referred to Angkor Wat, and is located north of provincial capital of Siem Reap. It's believed to have a history of not less than 1,200 years. This archaeological site cover an area of about 40,000 hectares and is made up of two main sections, namely the Angkor Wat or the Angkor Temple and Angkor Tomb. Now, with many smaller building structures scattered around this ancient city between the 40,000 hectares of land. Now, it's good to know something about this Khmer Empire. Khmer Empire is also known as Angkor Wat Empire, right? The empire started from the year 802 till 1431, right? Lasts about 600 years. It's a Hindu cum Buddhist empire. The site of Angkor was the capital of the Angkor Empire and were under the rule of 20 emperors. Among them, the famous emperors are Jayavarman II, which ruled from 802 till 835. He's a founder of the Angkor Empire and unified Cambodia kingdoms. Emperor Suyavarman II, which ruled from 1113 till 1150. He reunified the Cambodia and the construction of Angkor Wat. Then the Emperor Jayavarman VII ruled from 1181 to 1215. He regained the Angkor Wat from Cham, actually referred to Vietnamese, and the construction of Angkor Tomb, which include the Bayons, Prangka, Taprons, Bentekedei, and Sarasrang. Now from this 3D, right, so I'm going to share with you this 3D map. From this 3D tourist map of Angkor, archaeological site, it's roughly covered the entire site with illustration of the locations of all major temples and buildings of this ancient city. You will notice in this map, it's shown a lot of waterway or canals between the ancient city. The three of the major building complexes, namely the Angkor Wat, the Angkor Tomb, and the Prangkan, right, are surrounded by this waterway or canals. It's believed that this waterway or canals were built to serve three main purposes. Firstly, as a defense or deterrence against enemy attack. Secondly, as a flood water retention pond during the monsoon season. And lastly, as a water reservoir during the dry season. So with 40,000 hectares of land area, it is indeed a big site to explore. My visit only covered the Angkor Wat temples and part of the Angkor Tomb. So then let us focus only on these two spots. Now in this simplified map of Angkor Wat and Angkor Tomb, it's shown the path taken by me. Now I started at a point where most tourists took, that is entering the eastern gates or the main entrance of Angkor Wat and out from the western gate or rather it's Victoria Gates, right? Then heading north to South Gates of Angkor Tom, and assist from the Victoria Gate. So just now the entering is from the Eastern Gate and out from the Western Gate of Angkor Wat. So let's start from the entry point. Now before I move on, then let's share a bit about Angkor Wat background again. Angkor Wat built in early 12th century, it's been regarded as the biggest ancient temple building in the world. And with classic Khmer architecture, magnificent remains of Khmer civilizations is the center feature of Angkor UNESCO site, right? World Heritage Site, which was awarded in the 1992. This is the causeway we have to cross. This is the typical entry point for most tourists. So, in other words, the majestic monuments of Angkor Empire are the testimony of this ancient kingdom, right? And is of its immense power and wealth, with the impressive art and the accommodating of a variety of belief. So we are now entering the eastern or the main gate of Angkor Wat. It is still a long way to walk before come close to the temple building complex, as shown in the background of this image. So the insert showing the overall view of this Angkor Wat complex. So as we enter the temple buildings, right? So we are getting closer. This is actually the view. Of a last piece of open grass, spare grass field. Surrounding a temple building, which separating the so-called the external perimeter wall with the external enclosure wall of the temple building. Now, there are numerous entry points to the temple building at all four sides and also four corners of the buildings. The eastern side entry point has fewer steps and easier to access, and also the main entrance as seen in this image. Now, while the northern and southern entry points are more difficult to access due to the steepness of the stair and the height of the flight. So as seen in this and the next images. You literally have to crawl to ascend this step. It's constructed in such a way that it's impossible to stay upright because it will not be stable. So people who are actually ascending to this temple building, they are literally like crawling all the way up. And they believe that this is in the intention of why they built the steps so steep. Now this is the view from the top of the stair, look down. Now this image shows the eastern facade of the temple, which is enclosed completely with another layer of perimeter wall with cover alley or corridor. Could you spot the cover alley or corridor on both sides of this image? Yes, I'm sure you can. In this cover alley, this is where the famous intricate stone reliefs are located. It's on the external surface of the perimeter stone wall. Now, this image shows one of the four cover alley or corridor, the carving not only onto the wall's face, but also onto the surface of the cover alley or corridor, if you observe carefully. Now, this 30 meter plus of perimeter stone wall face of Angkor Wat temples are covered with intricate carving or reliefs, depicting scenes from the Hindu mythology. So I will share with you more close-up view. These are close-up views of part of the wall reliefs. Now, this image shows you the inner courtyard of the temple buildings. It's at higher ground now. And the entire courtyard was stone paved. Beside this famous stone wall, or stone reliefs, at the all corner of a temple building, we can also find famous wall release at all corners of the temple's building structure, and all of them are full of intricate carving, both interior and exterior. This image shows the stone carving on the column, of one of the columns. Now, this and the next three images show the external facade of the temple buildings. Due to limited time, I did not enter into the main temple building, which is at the highest point of the Angkor Wat temples. So, let's look at the map again. From the western gate of Angkor Wat, so after the visit, right, then to the south gate of Angkor Thom, there is a short distance to walk as shown in this route map, right? And while on the way to Angkor Thom, spotted this building remain. Sorry, I can't recall the name of this site. If any of you know about this, can you just leave a comment at this video page? Before I begin with the second part of my tour to Angkor Thom, let's get to know a bit more of this archaeological site of Angkor Thom. Please look at the map again, right? Now, the second section of Angkor archaeological site is Angkor Thom. It is the inner royal city of Angkor Empire, built at the end of the 12th century. And it's renowned for its temples, particularly the Bayon, with 216 number of stone faces. Angkor Thom is a large archaeological site, about six times larger than Angkor Wat temples. There are so many buildings and temple structures within Angkor Thom. Just name a few like the Bakhuns, Pimi Anakas, Terrace of Elephants, and Leper King. Just an example. Now, this is the external view of the south gate of Angkor Thom. View for Angkor Wat directions. Now, South Gate of Angkor Thom is famous for its emblematic face towers, as seen in this image. and the row of giant sculptures forming the railing of the causeway. And leading into the compound of Angkor Wat. Anyone who visit Angkor Wat, you could not afford to miss this place, the Bayon Temple. Now, as it is one of the many must-visit temples in this ancient Angkor city, Bayon Temple is an extensively decorated Khmer temple built in the late 12th or early 13th century and was the last state temple to be built in Angkor city. It is the only Angkorian state temple, right, which built primarily as the Mahayana Buddhist shrine dedicated to Buddha. So the Bayon most distinctive feature is the multitude of the serene and massive stone on many of its towers. Now there are all together 216 number of gigantic stone face built in this temple as seen in this image. Now beside the 216 number of gigantic stone face, the entire temple equally well decorated, right, with all kind of stone reliefs, right, as shown in this and the next few images. And in this image, this only proof that I have to prove that I've been there, right? This image was taken in the year 2007, so 14 years ago. Do I look young in this image? Yes. Now, of course, I did visit some other temples of buildings between the Angkor Wat, such as this Bapram in this image. But during my visit, it was undergone to restoration, so I did not spend much time here. In this image, this is a shrine, the Wat Phrang Ngoc, this is what the name given. Pardon me for not able to pronounce correctly. Here, this is the Tak Kho Temple, the Tak Kho Temple. Again, I did not spend much time in this temple. Then I met these two young kids in Angkor Wat compound. Now, the last few sections of my trip cover Elephant Terrace and its surrounding. Now in this image, you could spot many faces of elephant on this stretch of stone wall. Uh, This at this point of my journey to route fronting the elephant terrace, this is where I make a U-turn to my starting point. As I need to meet up with my tuk-tuk driver for my next destination, is one of the popular sunset destinations or a viewing point in this ancient city. And the time was around 6 p.m. at that time. So my tuk-tuk driver brought me to this spot to view the sunset. This place is known as Prawns Bak Heng, right? And the viewing point or platform is quite high above ground. It's about 10 meters, I believe, right? You can see from this image, the sky is very cloudy. In fact, thereafter it started to rain. And this is the reason why I left without any sunset images. Interestingly, this archaeological site also provides elephant rides. It seemed like no taker, and it was late evening now. As most tourists have gone back, you know, except latecomer like me visiting the site in the afternoon. Then this image showed the hotel I put a night of stay here. The room rate was about US dollar $30 per night at that time, or translate about 120 ringgit. Now the room rate did not include breakfast. Now this kind of hotel with less than 50 rooms capacity can be found abundantly in Siem Reap town and at a very reasonable rate. Now it was a cozy hotel with a lobby. Interior element inclusive of loose furniture were built of solid teak, one type of tropical hardwood species found abundantly in these regions. So like in this image, and the next image show the use of solid teak wood for its hotel lobby ceiling. You will be find very, very funny why I show you a keychain. Now the interesting part of this hotel is that I've received my room keys, and the key was attached to a solid iron rods of about 50 mm in length, or 2 inches, a heavy one. They use this to discourage the hotel guests from bringing out the room key. You can see the message here, you know, that the printed paper that grew onto this solid rocks of irons. Please leave your room key at the receptions. Interesting. This is how they prevent you from bringing out. And I have an excellent breakfast on the following day in Siem Reap. I believe it was one of the best meals of my trip to Cambodia. An authentic and local breakfast set comprises of French bread, stuffed with roasted bacon and seasoned cucumbers. And with a fresh, small plate of fresh salad, and plus, of course, a cup of local coffee as seen in this image. This is where they roast the bacon as well as the French bread all together. Now on the return journey, let's look at the map. It was a public bus ride. Right? The entire journey was traveling along the eastern bank of Tonisap lakes and river can be seen from the map. So you have the plenty of opportunity witnessing the vast paddy field. The, at the far end is actually the Tonisap lakes as seen in this image. And also you have opportunity to witness a plenty of villages dwellings along the entire roads. The countryside living lifestyle. And the journey took almost full 7 hours, inclusive a short break during the midway of the journey before reaching Phnom Penh. And here in this image, this was another interesting image during the return journey. On the way back, right, of course, plentiful of countryside scenes. So, before I end my travel log as promised, in the beginning of the episode here, here are some advice from me for travelers who plan to visit Angkor Wat in the near future. This 14 points pointer may serve as a guide. You are advised to do a check and double confirm with your local travel agency or hotel prior to your trip, as things may change. Firstly, put on a comfortable pair of walking shoes and a hat if you could, as you will be outdoor the whole day with a lot of walking. 2. Apply mosquito repellents and sunblock before your tour begin. This may be necessary. 3. Bring along an umbrella with you, even though if your visit is during the dry season. Of course, the best time to visit is during the dry season. The recommended months of travel is between November till January, which will be less rainy days, but you will miss the river cruise if you plan to take one, just like me. Now, as the temple sites are secret places, so wear only clothing that can cover your shoulders and knees. You may prevent from entry if your dressing is not appropriate. 5. Get extra drinking waters, and particularly if you plan to spend the whole day at the site. Although there are stores nearby selling snacks and drink and places for meal, but only at strategy point or locations. So if you don't want to waste time of coming to take a meal then travel back, then this is the best spot, best proposal. And always remember, do not litter, be a civilized traveler. Number 6. Currently, the entrance tickets available are in the form of a day, 3 or 7 day pass, a fare from $37 or about 150 ringgits, $62 about 255 ringgits, and $72 about 295 ringgits. You can buy your entrance pass a day earlier. This is particularly important for those appreciated photographers who want to capture the sunrise scene in Angkor Wat and then don't want to lose precious time in the morning. Now, in order to get a good spot, right, you need to be there early before the crowd arrive. The crowd was huge before the pandemic occurred. Now, the site opened to visitors at 5 a.m. This is mainly to cater for visitors wanted to capture sunrise scene. But most temples' gates between the site only open at 7:30 a.m. Now, it is a huge site. As such, you may need at least 3 full days to explore this ancient Angkor Wat city comprehensively. Plan your travel routes well in advance as to avoid the crowds. Go against the flow is my advice. Go to the less popular spot first, then follow the popular spot. Particularly if you are a photographer or videographer. If you engage a tuk-tuk, the driver, they will follow the normal routes. This is where all of the traveler or visitor are doing it. Tell them you want to go for reverse direction. Get them to agree with it. Then only you book this tuk-tuk or take on this tuk-tuk. Now, the recommended must visit temple, which I strongly recommended, the Angkor Wat temple, Angkor temple, the Bayon temples, the Bente Seri temple, the Prangka temples, the Tak Prong temples, Bente Kedi temples, and the Pra Vihir temple. Right. Sorry for the pronunciation. If your stay is long enough to cover all these places. As I mentioned earlier, in a day it's impossible. Even 3 days, it depends how you spend your time, how you maximize your time. That's why they have a 3 day and 7 day pass to cater for those who really want to go into very detail, very comprehensively cover this ancient site. And for photographer, or if whichever way is it, it's always like to wear, please wear light or bright color clothing. If you intend to take a lot of portraiture pictures, as the backgrounds are likely to be grayish in color behind you. So to make the image, the picture stand out, this is my advice to the visitor. Now, besides walking, there are other options. Options such as hiring of taxi and the tuk-tuk, right? The motorcycle taxi or the rental of bicycle are not a bad idea at all. And they are quite affordable. Also available is motorbike and car rental, but please take notes. The renting of motorbike and car by foreigner are not permitted. It's only for the local. Now, at Angkor Wat site, the archaeological site, the hiring of tuk-tuk on the spot for a full or half day is possible. Assuming you reach there, then only you decided not to walk and you want to hire a tuk-tuk. But it's going to cost you a higher price. As a guide, the general outside fare is about $20 per 8 hours or roughly about 80 ringgit per day. And the starting fare is $1 or about 4 dollars ringgit or 4 ringgit. So, another thing is that if necessary, plan your entry and exit point to Cambodia as shown in this map. Because, and it's reversible, they mean that you avoid doing the same journey, travel the same journey twice. But for my case, it's very unique because I took the boat rides from Phnom Penh to Siem Reap, then by land and come back to Phnom Penh. Fine, it's on by waterway and by on land. But if you are not, then in this case, it's maybe wise to visit either a Phnom Penh first, then only follow up with Siem Reap, then you fly off, or all the rivers. So this is the end of this episode for the same old saying. If you are entertained and you like my travel channels, please support by subscribing, share, and give me a thumb up. You know, of course, this is important to me. Now, lastly, in this pandemic, please stay safe and stay strong. See you guys next week in my next episode. All right, and my travel to a country side, right, of this Tony Sap Lakes and Cambodia, as well as Angkor Wat, is ended here, because this will be the last episode, and I will move on with another new nations. So stay tuned and see you next week. Bye.